story tonight with growing indications that First Lady Hillary Clinton may be indicted for her role in Whitewater. President Clinton is reportedly starting to prepare for that possibility. Plans so far include renting a hall, hiring a band, and making a giant bathtub with margaritas. Post has reported that Michael Jackson wants his closest friend in the world, Elizabeth Taylor, to be the godmother of his child. However, those close to the pair worry that this could eventually lead to heated arguments over whether the child will be molested or eaten. This week, Donald Trump announced that he won $20 million by betting on Evander Holyfield in his recent fight with Mike Tyson. Trump says he went public with his huge gambling win, just in case there are a few people out there who still don't hate him. And it's been reported that Keanu Reeves is engaged to actress Amanda Decadina. Asked to comment, Keanu said, "What? I thought I was gay. I'd always heard I was gay." In a dramatic finish to his White House bid, Bob Dole began a 96-hour, 15-state, non-stop campaign tour that will take him right through to Election Day. Political experts are calling the grueling marathon a, quote, last-ditch effort, while medical experts are calling it, quote, a suicide attempt. At a rally in California this week, Dole urged voters to ignore polls which have him trailing President Clinton by double digits. In addition, Dole asked them to ignore newspaper headlines next Wednesday that say Dole loses in landslide. Meanwhile, a new development in the case of John Wong, the mysterious Indonesian accused of illegally raising millions for the Democratic Party. Earlier this week, Secret Service logs showed that Mr. Wong had visited the Clinton White House more than 60 times. But on Friday, administration spokesman revealed that there are actually two John Wongs. Furthermore, they stressed that the John Wong who visited the White House is a different man. He isn't the fundraiser. He's the guy who killed Vince Foster. In an interview this week, Bob Dole said he is strong enough to handle the pain of losing the presidential election, although he did admit that the shock of winning would give him a giant heart attack. In Detroit, under a new prison rehabilitation program called Fresh Start, employers will get a tax break if they hire an ex-convict. Employers who hire more than one ex-convict will get robbed and killed. The long-running TV series The Love Boat is being made into a big-screen feature by New Line Cinema. The producers have announced that the entire original cast of Gavin McLeod, Bernie Capel, Fred Grandy, Ted Lange, Lauren Tweez, and Jill Whalen will have to pay $7.50 to see the movie just like everybody else. Story tonight in Los Angeles this week, Lyle and Eric Menendez were found guilty of first-degree murder. So, to review California law, it is killing your wife, legal. Killing your parents, illegal. Meanwhile, Simpson Dream Team attorney Alan Dershowitz was back in the news this week, and good Lord, is he ugly. Take a look at the guy. I mean, this is an ugly, ugly guy. No two ways about it. An ugly character. All right. In Paris, pop star Michael Jackson has announced a deal with a Saudi prince to launch an international chain of, quote, virtual reality wedding chapels. This makes this the most normal thing Michael Jackson has ever done. And in a recent interview, tenor Luciano Pavarotti says that he is so in love with his new girlfriend that he likes to run nude on the beach with her. Read all about this in this month's issue of Things That Make Me Vomit. That picture makes me vomit as well. Well, last year, wildfires throughout the western United States destroyed an estimated 50,000 acres and over 300 homes. Now many fear that with the new Republican-controlled Congress cutting the budgets of key federal agencies, such as the Forest Service and Army Corps of Engineers, fires this summer could be even more devastating. Here with a commentary, Frankenstein. Frankenstein! Frankenstein! Well, there's good news this week from strife-torn Ireland, where a historic peace agreement has just been signed. Gee, I wonder if anyone will celebrate by drinking. Former Interior Secretary James Watt was indicted this week for still having a large light bulb-shaped head. A stock market rally pushed the Dow Jones Industrial Average past the 4,000 mark for the first time ever. I have no idea what that means. Was O.J. Simpson high on speed the night of the murders? Absolutely not, said defense attorney Johnny Cochran today. And a simple test of any of O.J.'s blood found at the crime scene will prove it. And O.J. pal Al Cowling said this week that in looking for the truth in the O.J. Simpson case, he sometimes talks to a picture of Nicole Brown Simpson, something that in the past would have gotten him killed by O.J. If owners use replacement baseball players, hot dog vendors have vowed to go on strike. Boy, those owners are screwed now. Huh? They'll never find other guys who can sell hot dogs. I don't think so. New medical research shows that men and women have different food cravings. Men preferring meat and women preferring sweets. Scientists trace this back to caveman days, when men had to go out and hunt for food while women sat on their fat asses eating chocolates. The richest girl in the world, billionaire Athena Onassis, celebrated her 10th birthday this week. What's it like to be the richest girl in the world? Well, to give you some idea, at the party, they had two cakes. Judge Lancito this week barred all potential jurors from reading Faye Resnick's controversial new book, Nicole Brown Simpson, Life, Diary of a Life Interrupted. The judge also barred them from reading Faye Resnick's other new book entitled, Judge Lancito is a Big Fruit. In other book news, Prince Charles released an autobiography in which he states that he never loved Princess Di and that his father pressured him to marry her. The book is entitled, Of Course O.J. Did It, I Mean, Come On. And the Pope came out with a book this week, which contains a series of essays examining faith and morality in today's secular world and the changing role of the Catholic Church as it approaches the 21st century. The book is entitled, God Himself Told Me That O.J. Is Guilty. And finally, in honor of the 50th anniversary of their first publication, Random House will be releasing special commemorative issues of many Dr. Seuss classics. The first to hit the bookshelves will be Green Eggs and Ham and O.J. is Guilty. Judge Ito was interviewed this week by a local TV station in Los Angeles, asked by the interviewer if it was appropriate for a supposedly impartial judge to be on TV with his case still pending. Ito said, maybe not, but how appropriate is it to kill your ex-wife? It was revealed today that O.J. Simpson told police that Nicole Brown Simpson used to beat him up. He also claimed that she and Ron Goldman killed him. Talk show host Ricky Lake was arrested for vandalism after demonstrating against fur. She said wearing fur was in bad taste. then returned to her studio to tape a show entitled Why Whores Get the Clap. Yeah, Ricky, like, you know, she really is an animal lover, though. She has three cats, two dogs, and a big ass that follows her around everywhere. Well, there may be trouble in paradise. Lisa Marie Presley confirmed this week that she and Michael Jackson live in separate residences 50 miles away from each other. Lisa Marie was quoted as saying, I guess being married to a homosexual pedophile wasn't such a great idea after that. Researchers have developed a so-called red wine pill, which gives all the benefits of red wine without the alcohol. Yeah, it's called a grape. To restore passenger confidence. I think just two little words will do that. We've landed. Blimpies has started supplying subs for Delta Airlines to serve in its flight, and in return, Delta is giving Blimpies barf bags to hand out in its restaurants. Standing outside a New York City courtroom this week, Paula Jones was berated by passing New Yorkers who called her names such as slut and whore. Observers say the situation grew even worse when the crowd realized who she was. Kenny G has a Christmas album out this year. Hey, happy birthday, Jesus. Hope you like crap.